pretty normal guy, which is why he's so popular, and why so many second-rate journalists, especially other sports journalists, and especially journalists at the CBC, hate him, because he's better, and they hate that. So there was this fake storm of protest. They just faked it. No one real was upset by this, no normal people. It was all his rivals or leftist politicians, people who had been holding a grudge for years. And they started going nuts because Don Cherry is the last conservative in the mainstream culture. So here's a Trudeau MP tweet. He simply needs to leave hockey night. It's time. That's Peter Fragiscatos, who's a Liberal MP. So now we have the Liberal government saying who should or shouldn't be on television. Well, of course, it's Trudeau's Canada. And really, we know where the Liberals stand on veterans already, don't we?
First of all, why are we still fighting against certain veterans groups in court? Because they are asking for more than we are able to give right now.
Yeah, Mr. Fragiscatos is fine working for a party leader who's dressed up in blackface so many times he's lost count, but he can't stand a conservative being on TV. The CBC naturally led the war against Don Cherry. They're finally free to hate him out loud, as they did under their gritted teeth for decades. They hated him for years at the CBC, but they couldn't attack him publicly. He worked for the company. He was their most popular broadcaster. He paid all the bills. But now that he works for Sportsnet, 20 years of pent-up hatred came spilling out of the CBC. It was amazing to watch the CBC. If anyone actually watched the CBC anymore, I don't know. On a Sunday night, I'm guessing maybe 50,000 people watch CBC's The National out of 35 million Canadians. Here's why. Get a load of this woman, who I think is a weird bigot. I don't even know what the word racialized means. Do you mean visible minority? I don't know. And I notice she isn't wearing a poppy while she's shouting at Don Cherry. Take a look.
I don't need to be told by you that my poppy will represent my support of vets. I hated the way that he did that. I thought that he was absolutely looking and pointing fingers at people of color, racialized communities, because he didn't see enough poppies. So that translates into racialized communities not caring about this country. I'm sorry, it was unacceptable. I would love to see Don Cherry replaced.
Of course you would, dear, but we don't believe in censorship in Canada just because you're angry and call someone a racist, who, by the way, didn't mention race at all. And by the way, put on your poppy, you ingrate. Well, Don Cherry didn't apologize. He did not bend the knee. Why should he? He's 85. He's almost 86. He hasn't bent the knee to anyone in 85 years. Why would he start now? But the coward Ron McLean did. Watch one more time Don Cherry's normal Don Cherry-ness as his sidekick, Ron McLean, who is a millionaire because of Don Cherry. Watch Ron closely this time.
You know, I was talking to a veteran. I said, I'm not going to run the poppy thing anymore, because what's the sense? I live in Mississauga. Nobody wears, very few people wear a poppy. Downtown Toronto, forget it, downtown Toronto, nobody wears a poppy. And I'm not going to wait. He says, wait a minute. How about running it for the people that buy them? Now, you go to the small cities, and you know those, the rows on rows, you people love, you they come here, whatever it is, you love our way of life, you love our milk and honey, at least you could pay a couple of bucks for poppies or something like that. These guys pay for your way of life that you enjoy in Canada. These guys paid the biggest price. Anyhow, I'm going to run it again for you great people and good Canadians that bought a poppy. I'm still going to run it. Anyhow,
love you for it.
So if I'm counting right, there were five head nods, one love you for it, and one thumbs up there. But look at Judas McLean the very next morning.
I wanted to address what happened last night on Hockey Night in Canada. Don Cherry made remarks which were hurtful, discriminatory, which were flat out wrong. We at Sportsnet have apologized. It certainly doesn't stand for what Sportsnet or Rogers represents. We know diversity is the strength of the country. We see it in our travels with our show and with Hockey Night in Canada. So I owe you an apology too. That's the big thing that I want to emphasize. I sat there, did not catch it, did not respond. Catherine Denise, Tsitsana First Nation, once said, in any wrongdoing, the real key is recognition and acknowledgement. investment. And I wanted to let you know that first. And then you work on the relationship so that it isn't a visit, so that something can be a unifying event. Idle No More was a great lesson to all of us. Last night was a really great lesson to Don and me. We were wrong, and I sincerely apologize. And I wanted to thank you for calling me and Don on that last night.
Hurtful, discriminatory, flat out wrong? How? And stop lying. You say you sat there and did not respond? You didn't catch it? You absolutely did respond, you liar. Five nods, a thumbs up, and a love ya. Why are you trying to gaslight us? We saw what happened. And you're invoking Aboriginal moral authority or whatever weirdness you're trying to do there? Why not invoke Black Lives Matter, you woke weirdo, you betrayer of your best friend who made you a millionaire? Sportsnet called Cherry divisive and discriminatory. Really? I heard a guy encouraging all Canadians, old-timers and newcomers, to learn about our customs and buy poppies to show respect. But this is Sportsnet's version of taking a knee. They worship wokeness. And look at all the vultures. Here's the once second highest paid CBC talent, Peter Mansbridge, making a false accusation against the once highest paid talent at the CBC. The notion that Canada's veterans were all white is dangerously wrong and an insult to thousands, says Peter Mansbridge. Yeah, Peter, who said anything about only white veterans? What a kookaloo, Mansbridge, not Cherry. Cherry's the normal one. Who asked you, Peter? Is this some grudge against the guy who earned more money than you for decades? All the people who had nothing to say about Justin Trudeau's blackface had a lot to say about Don Cherry. That's an excerpt from The Ezra Levant Show, which is a show I do every day. I do a monologue, interview an interesting guest, and then I read my hate mail. But you've got to subscribe to it, which you can do at premium.rebelnews.com.